Good morning, church. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. I want to believe that when the Spirit of God realized that I have got tired when I was dancing with you, he knew I was tired. He said, okay, you can go out. Next time I will not join you, I want to see what the Holy Spirit will do. I will not join you. I will just decided not to avoid the service. I will keep myself separate place. I want to see what the Holy Spirit will do. But this time I was watching, dancing, follow everything that was happening. But something in me said, you need rest. Then the Holy Spirit said to me, go out. Hallelujah. You have your copy of the message that have been circulated. Hallelujah. Good morning once again. I want to say good morning to the viewers all over the world. Thank you, thank you. I want to thank you for your celebration, for joining us celebrating 11 years, Emmanuel TV. And we are still celebrating. I say we are still celebrating. Yes, you know, your birthday, after the week of your birthday and this next week to the birthday and the even throughout that month, is celebration for you, if I'm right. No, I know. I know many people that celebrated in the past the way they handle their celebration. So that month is celebration, whether in arrear or in advance, is celebration, if I'm right. So thank you. Hallelujah. Yes. Last week we talked about faith, and the same issue of faith will continue to link on and on. And I don't see myself leaving the word faith, because I don't know, everything about me, faith. Yes, it's faith. So let's begin where we stopped the last message. Talk on faith. Are you tired? Okay, I should talk of prosperity. Okay, let's talk of prosperity. Because you would like to hear that. I can see. You know, prosperity has to do with money and it's your friend. It's your friend. So we want to begin where we stop. Just give me your 10 minutes. And just to remind you of what we have been talking about in the past. Talk on faith. This time let's take our reading from the book of Matthew. That is the first book of New Testament. So I will open to chapter 21. As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage on the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go to the village ahead of you. And at once you will find a donkey tied down with a colt by her. I want to take you to the verse verse 18. I think that is where our proof test will actually begin. Jesus cursed a fig tree. Early in the morning, as Jesus was on his way back to the city, he was hungry. Seeing a fig tree by the road, he went up to it, but find something on it except leaves. Then he said to it, "May you never bear fruit again." Can you see? Because he could not find anything on the tree except leaves. Jesus said to the leaves, to the tree, "May you never bear fruit again." Immediately the tree withered. Immediately the tree withered. When the disciples saw this, they were amazed, surprised. What a manner of man is this? How did the fig tree wither so quickly? That is the thought. Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, if you have faith and you do not doubt, not only can you do what was done to the fig tree, but also you can say to this mountain, 'Go throw yourself into the sea,' and it will be done." This is that. Not only can you do to that, but you can say to the mountain also. Think about that. The last verse. Are you there? That is verse 22. He said, "If you believe, you will receive whatever you want, you ask in your prayer." If you believe. If you believe, you will receive whatever you ask. Can that be true of you? That is the question. If you believe, you will receive whatever you ask in prayer. Can that be true of you? That is the question you need to ask. Ask your neighbor, can that be true of you? I can't hear you. Again? The Bible is saying, if you believe, you will receive whatever you ask. Can that be true of you? Can that be true of you? That is the question. Because the word believe is not an application, but faith is an application. Faith is a demonstration. Faith is a conviction. Faith is an application. You want to apply. We can only apply all of God's blessing through faith. If you say you believe, show me your faith. I believe. Show me your faith. This is a question of the heart. This is a question of what? Of the heart. Faith is of man's heart. you may believe and not able to express your faith. You may believe and not able to express your faith. Anyone can believe, but not everyone can express their faith. I believe. Well, anybody can believe. Express your faith. Many believe, but unable to express their faith. Many claim to believe, but do not know how to believe. That is, many claim to say they are believers, but they do not know how to believe and express their faith. That is, many claim I'm a believer. That is what is going on all over the world. Everyone here say they are believers. If they ask you, I'm a believer. But they do not know how to believe and express their faith. See, I'm a believer. It's a talk of the town all over the world. Everybody claims they are believers. But they do not know how to believe and express their faith. Faith is an application. Faith is a demonstration. Faith is a conviction. Faith is practical. That is the work particle cash. I see fruit. Yes, I can see this fruit. That is belief. Yes, this is fruit in my hand. That is faith. That is you and Jesus. I demonstrate again. Your relationship with Jesus. Those who claim they are believers. Yes, that is fruit. I believe it's fruit. Yes, it's fruit. This is fruit. It's fruit. Now the word faith now. This faith. You have faith to take it. Without faith, you say believe, you continue to see it. You continue to see the power, you continue to see the deliverance, you continue to see every of all of God's blessing, but you will not be able to apply it to yourself or make them manifest in you. It is by faith we make all of God's blessing manifest in us. It is by faith we can apply all of God's blessing. I take it again. By faith we can apply all of God's blessing. By faith we can manifest in us all of God's blessing. It's a question of faith. It's a question of the heart. Whom we believe, whom we trust. Simple. Whom we trust. You can say, I believe, but you believe. not with your heart. It's a question of what? The question of the heart. Bible is full of promises for every matter. There are promises in the Bible that God will do for us as long we have faith. Walk without faith is dead. In the same way, faith without work is dead. What we do express what we believe. What we do express what we believe. If our faith and work do not agree with our faith, something is wrong with our faith. That is, if our faith do not agree, something is wrong with our faith. The matter is quite simple. Faith is expressed through work. Faith work together with its work. By this, faith is perfect. By this, faith is proved. By this, faith is completed. Simple. If you say you believe, where is your faith? Because faith is practical. Believing in our heart is released by faith. The belief in our heart can only be released by faith. If not, your belief will remain dormant, inactive. Okay, you can believe, but it's dormant. If our belief remain dormant, what is dormant? It's what? If you say you have money and you cannot spend it, do you have money? You say you have money. You are rich, but you cannot spend the money. Can you say you have money? Because you will need money. It means you will be borrowing money. When you have money and you cannot spend them, it means you will be borrowing money. You become a debtor. So, belief in our heart can only be released by faith. So, when you don't have faith, belief in your heart will remain dormant. So, are you a Christian? When there is no faith, the belief in your heart will remain dormant. So, how will you call Jesus? How will you talk to Jesus when the belief in your heart is dormant? In Jesus' name, you need faith. But there's no faith to release the belief. Amen. You can only say amen. By faith, release your belief in your heart. But it's not released. Thank you, Jesus. You can only say this when faith releases the belief in your heart. But the belief in your heart is dormant. This is why I share many claim to be a believer, but do not know how to believe and spread their faith. They claim to be believers, but they do not know how to believe and express their faith. If we believe in God in a matter, in a certain matter, you believe in God in a certain matter, you should have faith, you should have work of faith in that matter. Tell your neighbor, if you believe in God in a certain matter, you should have work of faith in that matter. Again, again, that is, if we believe in God in a certain matter, we should have work of faith in that matter. Because work without faith is dead. Faith without work is dead. It means without work of faith, that belief is dead. And what is work of faith? That is the question. Simple. Work of faith can simply be defined in this way. Absolute trust in God that He is working out the answer. He is now working out the answer. That is the work of faith. Tell your neighbor again, absolute trust in God that He is now working out the answer. Again, I can't hear you. He is now working out the answer. Absolute trust in God that He is now working out the answer. That is work of faith. If I say I believe God, if I say I believe God is working for me, I now busy making my own plan, worry, distress, this must force faith. Force faith. If a man say he believes that God is working for him, but is busy making his own plan, worry at the same time and distress, this must force faith. This must force faith. Force faith, not be force faith. Take note, writer. This must force faith. You quite understand what I mean by absolute trust. Now, see, I'm about to go out early morning. I realized that this cloud was darker, about to rain. I now move in to my bedroom and begin to pray. Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, I don't want this rain. I want to go to my walk. I want to go to my walk. Lord Jesus, help me stop this rain. I say, okay, thank you, Jesus. I say, God has answered my prayer. I now move and I say to my family, thank you, I'm going to walk. It will not rain. I have prayed to God. And God said to me, it will not rain. At the same time, I moved towards umbrella. And I put umbrella inside my bag. And I put it on my shoulder. I said, thank you, Jesus. I say, thank you, Jesus. And I'm going to walk. What is the work of, what does that umbrella mean? In case it's war, that has nullified my war, my belief. That alone has nullified my belief. Because if I actually believe in a certain matter, I must have work of faith in that matter. Carry umbrella is not work of faith. Work of faith, absolute trust. If you cannot believe God with medicine, you will not believe him without medicine. If you cannot believe God with medicine, with tablet in your pocket in case you collapse here, tablet is already somewhere in case, if you cannot believe him with the medicine, you cannot believe him without medicine. We are still talking of talk on faith. Now I want to leave you. Let's now look at what is faith. Let's give another good example. You pray over some trouble which arise in your life, and later you find yourself full of anxiety and worry, as if you have never prayed before. Are you with me? I take it again. Take your pen. All right. You pray over some matter, some issue, some trouble which arise in your life, and later you find yourself full of anxiety. After the prayer, Oh, what will I do? Okay. I received phone call again over the matter. You have prayed and you have agreed God is in control, but worry. As if you never prayed at all. Prayer should be followed by absolute trust in Him, that He is now working out the answer. Tell your neighbor, prayer. Prayer should be followed by absolute trust in God that He is now working out the answer. Again? Again? I can hear you again. Again and again. Again and again. Yes. After you finish praying, what should follow? Absolute trust. Jesus, Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. What are you thanking Him for when you know He has not answered your prayer? After thanking, why full of anxiety and worry? And you say to me, Joshua, I need apple. Now, TB Joshua now giving you an apple. The next, thank you, TB Joshua. Thank you, Joshua. Thank you, Joshua. To be joyful, happiness to follow. Joy and happiness to follow all the rest until you finish the apple. But in this case, after you have received, you claim, thank you, you have received the apple. You are now find yourself full of anxiety and worry. Just as you never pray at all. If you know you have not received, why are you saying thank you, Jesus? Because every prayer ends by what? Well, let me take you back. I know where your problem come from. If you have not received teaching, or you have not received the promise of Father, Holy Spirit in your spirit, forcing to do such hard, indeed, is a risk. That is where your problem comes from. Forcing to do such hard, indeed, is a risk. I believe many of us have not received the promise of Father in our spirit. That is, you need to be grounded in the word of God. Faith comes by hearing. Since we have not heard and obeyed enough, you cannot add faith. That is where our problem comes from. You might have heard the word, but you have not obeyed what you hear. You hear it to teach it. You hear it to practicing it, not hearing it to live it. All the hearing the word of God, not to live it, but to teach it. and to I mean, you want to teach people, you want to use it to prove that you are a Christian. These are the reasons why you hear the word of God. You can argue it anywhere. I mean, born again, you start telling them from Genesis to Revelation where the word this, that this, what you hear the word of God for. Or you hear the God to become a preacher and teacher. So become a teacher and teach the word of God. People say you're a good teacher. From Genesis to Revelation, you know where those verses are. These are the reasons why you hear the word of God. But not to live it. If you have not here to live, you cannot act faith. If you act faith, indeed, it's a risk. I think this is why the challenge we have now. You only stop there, stop in a way, I believe. Like father of demon possessed, he said, I believe, help my own belief. He was acting like us then. He was acting like us. That is why he said to Jesus, I believe, help my own belief. If you believe, which can believe again? I believe, help my own belief. Me, I have been hearing the word of God. Not to leave them, but to teach them and to use it for my own selfish reason, become a teacher and preacher. This is why I hear the word of God and I learn the word of God. You say, I believe, help my own belief. That kind of belief is like the belief we have today. This is what the father of demon possessed said to Jesus. I believe, help my own belief. What kind of belief again? If you believe and you are asking him to help your own belief, it means the belief he had was a kind of hearing the word of God to preach and to teach, not to live the word. If you hear the word of God and live it, you act it. So this is why we keep seeing the present darkness. Physical eyes will always and will continue seeing the present darkness. And the eyes of faith will always see the light. The present darkness is the situation you are now. Your challenges now are the present darkness, and this is only thing you can see. You can't see beyond your situation. That is why you lament, you cry, you doubt, sober, anxiety, worry, because all you can see is your present darkness. You cannot see beyond your present darkness. As long as you have faith, you'll be able to see the light. Physical eye can only see what? Present darkness. Tell your neighbor. Our sight can only see the present darkness. But the eyes of faith can see the light. And what is the present darkness?